ఓకే మన టాపిక్ వచ్చేసి జియోటెక్నికల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్. జియోటెక్నికల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అంటే ఏంటో మనం చూద్దాం. సో ద స్టడీ ఆఫ్ ఎర్త్ ఇన్ టెక్నికల్ మేనర్ ఈజ్ నోన్ యాజ్ జియోటెక్నికల్ ఇంజనీరింగ్. సో ఓకే, జియో మీన్స్ ఎర్త్ అండి. ద మెయిన్ జియో మీన్స్ ఎర్త్, టెక్నికల్ మీన్స్ టెక్నికల్ మేనర్ మీన్స్ వీ కెన్ స్టడీ ఇన్ లెటర్ యాజ్ compressibility, consolidation, permeability, shear stress. So like we are discussing these points in technical manner to the soil or to the earth is known as geotechnical engineering. Okay, what about soil mechanics means? Soil mechanics means is here you can see that the principle of mechanics and hydraulics also. The principle of mechanics and hydraulics is applied to the soil, then it is known as soil mechanics. Mechanics means mechanics. So principle of mechanics and hydraulics which are applied to the soil, then it is known as soil mechanics. So with the application of soil mechanics and foundation engineering, we can call it as geotechnical engineering. Okay, the application of soil mechanics and foundation engineering is known as geotechnical engineering. So mainly the soil mechanics means the principle of mechanics and hydraulics is applied to the soil, then it is known as soil mechanics. Okay, now as per we have so many definitions related to soil mechanics, so forgot about only just one or two definition is enough. Next one, soil. The main definition is soil as per Terzaghi. So mostly important question is what is mean by soil as per Terzaghi. So the soil meaning as per Terzaghi is the soil is unconsolidated material composed of solid particles produced by physical and chemical weathering of rocks, not disintegration, weathering of rocks, may also organic matter. I will explain with in Telugu. So unconsolidated means it is not very compacted by above the soil material. Okay, next it is composed of solid particles. It may be presents any particles, any type of large cell or small cell, and also by these all particles are how produced by physical and chemical disintegration of rocks or chemical decomposition of rocks. Okay, so by this parameter, with this phenomena, the soil is formed. So as per Terzaghi, soil is an unconsolidated material. That means no external forces are applied on the soil material, and the soil is formed by physical and chemical weathering of rocks, or we simply say the physical disintegration or chemical decomposition of rocks, may also organic matter. For this example, may also organic matter means మీళ్ళలో చెట్లు కానీ ఏదైనా మొక్కలు కానీ లేకపోతే ఏదైనా ఏమంటారు జంతువులు కానీ చచ్చిపోయినప్పుడు అవి ఆటోమేటిక్గా అవి కొన్ని రోజులు అలా పడిపోయి ఏమవుతాయి మీ డాబాల మీద ఇళ్ళ మీద ట్యాంకుల్లో ఏమవుతాయండి అవి చిన్న చిన్న ఫైన్ పార్టికల్స్గా ఫామ్ అవుతాయి. సో ఇలా కూడా మనకి ఆర్గానిక్ మ్యాటర్ కూడా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. మీకు ఇంకా క్లియర్గా చెప్పాలంటే చిన్నపిల్లలు పుట్టేటప్పుడు బయటకు వచ్చిన తర్వాత వాళ్ళ గోర్లలో మట్టి ఉంటుంది. సో అంబో దేవుడు మనల్ని మట్టితో పుట్టిస్తాడని అట్లా చెప్తుంటారు. సో దానికి రీజన్ ఏంటంటే ఆ గోర్లలో ఏంటంటే మొత్తం అంటారు అందులో మొత్తం ఆ గర్భాశయంలో అన్నీ కలిపి ఉంటాయి. సో అవన్నీ గోర్లలోకి వెళ్ళిపోయి అవి డికంపోజ్ అయిపోయి అలా సాయిల్ గా ఫామ్ అవుతుంటాయి. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ బయోలాజికల్ ప్రాసెస్ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ ట్రీట్ యాజ్ సాయిల్. Okay, so many applications of geotechnical engineering. We are discussed with these points in later, that means in soil mechanics 2 or geotechnical engineering 2, like otherwise a foundation engineering. So these are applications to foundations, earth retaining, stability of slopes, underground pavements, so many etc. We can discuss in later. So okay, so many people are coming in. Okay, next one. So that is the first one. So again, soils are formed. Soils. Previous I will discuss as per Terzaghi only. Now the soil is formed either by weathering of rocks. Soils are formed by weathering of rocks. Weathering means the physical disintegration or chemical decomposition or biological process. It converts small particles and the soils are formed. So very big rocks are formed into fragmented into or broken into small particles. So these small particles is constitutes we called as soil. Okay, so soils are formed by weathering of rocks. If you say forgot about these points, at least you should be right only for approximately soils are formed by weathering of rocks only. These weathering of rocks is due to mechanical disintegration or chemical decomposition or biological process. Okay, so next one, geological cycle. The main soil cycle, or simply say the soil cycle, how soil are formed. So it is a parent rock or any hill. In hilly areas, so many rocks, big rocks are available. So these rocks are caused by erosion. The erosion may be due to physical disintegration or chemical decomposition. The physical and chemical disintegration we will discuss in the below. Okay, so due to erosion, the big rocks are breaking into small particles, and these particles are transported by wind, water, and any other materials. Due to this presence of rocks, are transported by wind, water, and it is deposited by at a lower level areas. Due to a continuous process, the one layer is deposited, and another layer over the another layer, it is deposited again. Okay, no problem, sir. Once if the fragmented particles are transported to by wind or water and it is deposited at one place, if deposited at one place, one layer is formed. Again, in next academic, next year or next 10, again if the particles are transported and deposited, and so many layers are formed. So due to the below layers are occur pressure due to the above layers, and also from bottom we have heat. So above pressure, below heat. So due to the pressure, these solid particles, these suspended materials formed due to a rock. So due to these suspended materials and formed like rock, and the rock is going upward, well, the tectonic plates or any other external forces acting on the force, and again hills or rocks may be formed. Again, same process will repeat. This is the geological cycle. Okay, one more point is, if the soils are formed at or near the parent rock, is known as sedimentary or sedentary or residual soils. For example, I will give you an explanation for this. Okay. Here a hill or parent rock is available. If the rocks fragments are due to physical and chemical decomposition, these rocks, broken rocks are appeared or maybe present only near this hill or near this parent rock, then this type of soils is known as sedentary soils or residual soils. Okay. If the soils are formed at near the parent rock, okay, near the hill or near the parent rock, if the soils are present, then it is known as sedentary or residual soils. Okay. Otherwise, if the soils are formed here and it is transported and deposited to another place, so then the type of soils is known as sedimentary soils or transported soils. Okay, so those are known as transported soils. So if the soils are formed at one location and finally deposited at other location, those soils are known as sedentary soils or residual soils. Okay, so due to the main difference between residual and transported soils are the properties are approximately equal to parent rock, because here is the parent rock and it is reaches to bottom. So same properties and same materials are available at near the parent rock. So residual soils are approximately same to the parent rock, but transported soils are it is weathering process and erosion process and transportation process and decomposition below heating, above pressure. So due to this, the properties of soils are different from parent rock. Okay, so remember that point. Okay. Now the formation of soil is the most important. Throughout the first topic, it is the most important topic is formation of soil. The formation of soil may be due to the weathering of rocks. Due to the weathering of rocks may be physical disintegration or chemical decomposition or biological process. Mainly physical disintegration or chemical decomposition, or mainly biological processes may not. Okay, so in the physical disintegration, so many points are available. Chemical decomposition, so many points are available. So I will discuss one by one. So here, so soils are formed by the due to this process weathering. So it is one of the effect of weathering of rocks. It is also one of the effect of weathering of rocks. So I will discuss one by one. So first one. So it is first one is temporary changes. Temperature changes. The first process temperature changes. So you know in engineering geology, the rock will be formed by constituted by many minerals. Okay. So due to the many minerals, the some rocks are due to the during day the rocks are heating and it is expand. Where it is night, it is cooling and it is contract. So due to alternating drying and wetting, that means due to daytime it is heating and expanded. In night time it is cold and it is contract. So it is alternation processes. It may disintegrated into small rocks. Okay. For example, I will give an example. Baga vedi vedi ga unna bulb meeda manchi 10 candles ay eda paathakalam bulb lu unnai kada avu intha mundu uttigina bayil pay ela ante baga vedi ga unna bulb meeda chinna drop of water ayyandi ee roju meer intlo emmate break ayipothundi ventane. So due to anni area lo nemo heat tho expand ay untundi meer drop vesin daggara em avutundi water valla adi cool ayipoyi contract avutundi. So bayata unnemo expand ay lopada contract ay ventane sudden ga bulb ane failure avutundi. So due to the rapid changes in the temperature, the rock minerals expanding and contracting automatically to disintegrate and disintegrated into many rocks. Okay, so this is one of the example. Okay, sometimes this is also known as exfoliation. Okay, next one it is the wedging action of ice. So wedging action of ice means if any rock may present any small crack present. Due to the crack present, if any external water present into the or reaches into the in this crack in the rainy season, the water present in the rock. In winter season, it automatically the water may be transferred into ice. But ice have 9% is above volume of its water. So due to increasing in volume, the ice may acts external forces acting on the near sides of the parent rock. Due to these external forces, acting on the rock, the crack is propagated. So here you can see that here the crack is only here. Due to this ice formation, the external forces acting on the parent rock, the crack is prolonged. So like this. Next year, the water again present in this crack and it is frozen in ice. And the, due to the frozen of ice, the volume is extended and it is, creates an external forces acting on the edges of the rock and it is breaking. Okay, so continuously this progress is going. So finally, the rock is disintegrated into small fractions. Okay, like this, the soils are formed. So for example, like these examples, we have. If you are observing in our college, Anibisan, opposite to the Anibisan College, this type of weathering of rock also present. Next one, spreading of roots of plants. So next, this is the one example of weathering of rocks. If the same process, if the same manner, here water is available. If the plant root is penetrated to the rock, due to the growing process of this plant, the widening of the roots because of its increasing of its root. So it creates again external forces acting on the soil rock. So due to this external force acting on the rock, due to again this may be cracks further growing, increasing, and crack going further increases. So automatically it again breaks. Okay, so this is the example of spreading of roots into the cracks. if any crack is present due to the presence of water and any matter, the plants will grow. Due to the growing process, the plant spreads, the root is spread into the crack and it is widening through while developing of this tree. So automatically the edges of the rock automatically get external forces and it is cracks will going. Okay, so this is the process. Next one, abrasion. So you all know that it is well known that abrasion. So and also it is one more process is borrowing animals. Some of the rocks it is also actually it is biological process, not so due to the wind. So some of the rocks are continuously and repeatedly the weathering action of rocks due to the wind. So due to wind the particles are continuously going. It may be smoothened by due to hot wind and etc. And also due to the rubbing action of or maybe it may be formed due to the transportation. While transportation from upper to lower, if the rock is big and if fallen from top to bottom and it is small fragments are break into parts and it is finally small fragments are formed. And another process also we know that the due to this process, okay, away from the rock, top on the hill, the rocks present and it dropping from higher place to bottom place, and also the rocks of small fragments are broken and it is formed like a small rocks. And also due to the main process is water. The weathering of rocks also may be due to wind, water, and so many. Okay, wind, water, mainly wind water is present. Due to continuous flowing of water on the rocks, the small, that means ఏమంటారంటే ఆ పార్టికల్స్ రాక్స్ మీద వాటర్ అనేది కంటిన్యూస్ గా ఫ్లో అవుతూ ఉండేసరికి అండ్ అలల వల్ల ఒకరాయి అటు ఇటు మోతూ రబ్బింగ్ అయ్యి ద స్మాల్ పార్టికల్స్ ఉన్నటువంటి ఫ్రాగ్మెంట్స్ అన్ని ఊడిపోయి మనకి స్మూత్ గా ఫామ్ అవుతుంటాయి. ఇలా మనకి రివర్స్ లో కానీ సాండ్స్ లో కానీ ఎనీ లేక్స్ లో కానీ మనకు అప్పుడప్పుడు ఇలాంటి స్మూత్ గా ఉన్నటువంటి సాండ్స్ రాక్స్ అనేవి కనబడతాయి. ఇవి ఎందుకు కారణం మామూలు రాళ్ళే, కాకపోతే ఏంటంటే వాటర్ యొక్క వెదరింగ్ వల్ల కంటిన్యూస్ వేవ్స్ అటాక్ అవడం వల్ల అటువంటి రాక్స్ అనేవి ఈ విధంగా ఫామ్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి. ఓకే, సో డ్యూ టు దిస్ ఆల్ ప్రాసెస్ మన డ్యూ టు ద అబౌ దిస్ ఆల్ ప్రాసెస్ ద ఫిజికల్ డిస్ఇంటిగ్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ రాక్స్ ఈస్ అవైలబుల్. సో ఇన్ టెంపరేచర్ చేంజెస్ సో మెనీ లైక్ so all many process the physical disintegration of rocks is available. While going to chemical process, chemical decomposition, so it is a process of next chemical weathering. So there is no pictures for this, I will explain with my lecture notes only. So hydration, so generally you know that the water, hydration means water. The water combines with the minerals of rock. Generally, any rock have constitution of all minerals. So, due to water combines with the minerals and form a new compound. So, due to the chemical reaction, due to the increasing of due to the chemical reaction, the it increases its volume. So, due to increase its volume, automatically it creates external forces in the internal of a rock. Automatically after due to number of cycles, automatically the rock is disintegrated into many fragments. Okay, next one, in the carbonation process, we know that a carbon dioxide is present in our atmosphere and the carbon dioxide is reacts with the water and it forms carbonic acid. This carbonic acid means it very highly decomposable. So when the carbonic acid reacts with the rock, automatically the parent rock is automatically decomposes into another material. So due to acid, the rock is disintegrated into or decomposes into many fragments. Next one, oxidation. The main we can simply call it as corrosion. Oxidation means oxygen ions present in the atmosphere and reacts with the some of the minerals in the rocks and constituents combines oxidation ions and minerals forms a corrosion material like corrosion materials. Simply say that oxygen ions rock lo unnatundi minerals tho reaction charipi oka oxidation material ledha new compound form chestundi. Ee new compound entante again daniki volume anedi increase avutundi. So due to increase in volume again the external cracks will be formed. So due to this is the main number of process, the automatically the rock will be disintegrated into number of parts or maybe constitution of many minerals. Okay, next one, solution. It is the main I will give an example of leaching. మనకి తెలుసు బొర్ర గుహలు ఎల్లోర గుహలు ఇవన్నీ ఎలా ఫామ్ అయ్యాయంటే ఓకే ఓకే కార్బొనేషన్. కార్బొనేషన్ అంటే ఏంటంటే కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ కనుక కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ లో ఉంటుంది కదా ఆక్సిజన్తో పాటు, ఎప్పుడైతే కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ అనేది వాటర్తో రియాక్షన్ జరిపినప్పుడు, ఎందుకంటే వాటర్ అనేది ఆ రాక్ మీద కానీ ఎప్పుడైనా లేదా రాక్ లో పెనట్ అయినప్పుడు వాటర్ కానీ, సో ఈ కార్బన్ డైఆక్సైడ్ వాటర్ రెండు రియాక్షన్ జరిపి కార్బోనిక్ యాసిడ్ గా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. ఈ యాసిడ్ అనేది ఆటోమేటిక్ గా రాక్ మీద పడగానే ఏమవుతుంది, రాక్ అనేది కరిగేసి కొత్తగా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. సో రాక్ అనేది కరిగేసి ఏమవుతుంది, స్మాల్ పార్టికల్స్ గా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. సో ఈ విధంగా కూడా మనకి సాయిల్ అనేది ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. సేమ్ అదే విధంగా ఆక్సిడేషన్ కూడా సేమ్. సొల్యూషన్, సొల్యూషన్ అంటే ఏంటంటే కొన్ని కొన్ని రాక్స్ అసలు డైరెక్ట్ గా వాటర్ తో డైరెక్ట్ గా రియాక్షన్ జరిపేసి ఈజీగా అవి యొక్క డైరెక్ట్ గా వాటర్ తో రియాక్షన్ జరిపేసి డైరెక్ట్ గా అవి ఒక సొల్యూషన్ ఫామ్ అయిపోయి అలా బయటకు వచ్చేస్తుంది. సింపుల్ చెప్పాలంటే సాల్ట్ వాటర్, సాల్ట్ ఉంది, సాల్ట్ పక్కన వాటర్ పోతుంది అనుకుంటే సాల్ట్ వాటర్ తో కరిగేసి ఆ సాల్ట్ మొత్తం కొట్టబోతుంది. సేమ్ ఇలాగే మనకి బొర్రాకి పోవాలి ఇవన్నీ అలా ఫామ్ అయినాయి అనమాట. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ హైడ్రాలసిస్. ద వాటర్ ప్రజెంట్ ద వాటర్ మేబీ డిసింటిగ్రేటెడ్ వాటర్ మేబీ హ్యావింగ్ హైడ్రోజన్ అయాన్స్ అండ్ హైడ్రోజన్ అండ్ హైడ్రాక్సిల్ అయాన్స్. The hydrogen ions replacement by calcium or sodium or potassium. So whenever the hydrogen ions are replaced by the minerals of calcium, sodium, potassium, so automatically the new compound will be formed. So due to new compound form, automatically the parent rock will be decomposed into another particles. So the all process, the chemical decomposition is going. So the parent rock is decomposes into న్యూ మెటీరియల్. ఓకే ఓకే హైడ్రేషన్ మీన్స్ వాటర్ కంబైన్స్ విత్ మినరల్స్ ఫామ్ ఏ న్యూ కాంపౌండ్ అండ్ డిసింటిగ్రేటెడ్ ఇన్ టు మెనీ ఫ్రాగ్మెంట్స్. కార్బొనేషన్ యాసిడ్ రియాక్ట్స్ విత్ ద వాటర్ సారీ యాసిడ్ రియాక్ట్స్ విత్ ద మినరల్ ఫామ్ ఏ డికంపోజెస్ ది రాక్. ఆక్సిడేషన్ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి లైక్ యాజ్ కరోషన్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ బయోలాజికల్ ప్రాసెస్. ఎనీ బ్లడ్ ప్లాంట్స్ ఆర్ బారోయింగ్ ఆఫ్ అనిమల్స్ లైక్ హియర్ like borrowing of animals. So in the developing of their growth and increasing of their population, so they are spreading any algae or like any matter on the present of the rock due to in the increasing of process and also due to the growing of process it forms a something it releases some any acids and automatically the soils are formed. This process is not happens in single day or one day, 1 month or 1 year. It continuously many years. So while forming this type of we are seeing the above our soils. These soils are formed due to the many number of years, not a single day or not single year. In many years the rocks are transferred into soils. Okay, this is the examples. Next one. Next, if you clearly, if you not understand, I will explain again. In the summer season, in the day season, rocks are having different constituents of minerals. Each mineral having different coefficients of expansions. So due to temperature, increasing temperature, each mineral having different types of coefficients. Due to the increasing while night season the of some of the minerals getting contract, some of the minerals do not get contract. So due to this alternate drying and wetting and dry, in some in day and night due to the chemical number of concentrations of minerals expand and contract. So due to alternation of expand and contract, automatically the rock will break. Okay, so break once the break once rock will crack or break, so the water will be going and further actions and plant and other plants will grow up and again the rocks will be more disintegrated into many small particles. So like it is a continuous process, not a single process, but one process is related to another process. This is known as soil formation. Next one, soil structure. The soil structure means next one, so next important item is next one. So due no change in chemical composition, due to physical disintegration, no change in chemical composition, because just rock is separated into two parts. Again, the two parts is separated into four parts. So that's why in physical disintegration, rocks are disintegrated into just parts. So therefore, the original parent rock having same properties with reference to the new rocks, new what means new fragments. Okay, the parent rock having same properties related to the newly formed mineral, newly formed rocks. Okay, next one, properties are related to the parent rock. So there is no change in chemical composition due to physical disintegration. Mainly coarse grained soils are formed. So while observing, so many big particles are formed. So high parent rock is broken into small particles, gravels and sands. Okay, this is a form. So due to this physical disintegration, non-cohesive soils are formed. Cohesive means it is not attraction between the particles. Okay, non-cohesive means no attraction between the particles. That means it is contact by only interparticle forces or gravitational forces only, not attraction between the same particles. Okay, like next one, while chemical decomposition, each and every process, some minerals react with the any hydration, carbonation, oxidation and hydrolysis, and combine all these process and formed a new compound. So therefore, original mineral is combines with the these hydration carbon and formed into a new compound. So therefore, they absolutely due to chemical composition, there is a change in chemical composition. So therefore, original rock is one, and due to composition, due to the reaction, another color will form, another compound will form. So therefore, the properties are different from parent rock. Okay, so due to decomposition, the minute fine particles are formed. That means fine grained soils are formed. So silt and clay, for example, silt and clay, banka matti leda erra matti leda danikante koncham size ekkuva unnatundi soils form avutayi. Due to the chemical decomposition, fine grained soils are formed. For examples of fine grained soils, silt and clay. So these silt and clay have cohesive nature. That means the attraction between the particles is very high. మీకు ఒక ఎగ్జాంపుల్ చెప్తాను. ఇప్పుడు కంకర్ రాళ్లతో కానీ, అంటే డ్రైగా ఉన్నటువంటి ఇసుకతో కానీ మీరు ఏమన్నా బొమ్మలు చేయాలంటే చేయలేరు, ఎందుకంటే వాటికి అట్రాక్షన్ ఉండదు. అదే బంకమట్టితో కానీ ఇంకేదైనా ఎర్రమట్టితో కానీ మీరు బొమ్మలు తయారు చేస్తే, ఎలా చేస్తే ఆ పార్టికల్ అలాగే ఉంటుంది, ఆ బొమ్మ అలాగే ఉంటుంది. సో అంటే దానికి ఏంటంటే ఆ పార్టికల్కి మధ్య కోసివ్ ఫోర్సెస్ చాలా ఎక్కువగా ఉంటాయి కాబట్టి, దానికి కోసివ్ నేచర్ ఎక్కువగా ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి కాన్స్టిట్యూటెడ్ గా ఒక దగ్గరే ఉంటాయి. సో ఫైన్ గ్రెయిన్ సాల్ట్స్ కి కోసివ్ నేచర్ ఉంటుంది, కోర్స్ గ్రెయిన్ సాల్ట్స్ కి కోసివ్ నేచర్ ఉండదు. ఓకే, సో నాన్ కోసివ్ మీన్స్ నో అట్రాక్షన్ బిట్వీన్ ద పార్టికల్స్ అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ ద ఫోర్స్ యాక్టింగ్ బిట్వీన్ ద పార్టికల్స్ ఓన్లీ గ్రావిటేషన్ ఫోర్స్ అండ్ మేబీ ఫ్రిక్షన్ ఓన్లీ. ఓకే, ఫ్రిక్షన్ అండ్ గ్రావిటేషన్ ఫోర్స్. ఇన్ కోసివ్ సాల్ట్స్ ఓన్లీ ద అట్రాక్షన్ బిట్వీన్ ద సాయిల్ పార్టికల్స్ డ్యూ టు స్ట్రాంగ్ అట్రాక్టివ్ ఫోర్సెస్ డ్యూ టు అయాన్స్ అండ్ కేటయాన్స్ సో మెనీ లైక్ దట్. Okay, this is the main process of formation of soils. Soils are formed by weathering. Again, I am repeating you, soils are formed by weathering of rocks. The weathering of rocks may be due to the physical disintegration and chemical decomposition of rocks. Okay, in physical disintegration, temperature changes, wedging of action of splitting of group separation. Okay, hydration means carbonation, oxidation, solution. These all are going to chemical decomposition. Okay, I hope you understand. Okay. Okay.